That's his case. It is different. He was a sacrifice. A sacrifice for sin. And a sin which he did not commit. Praise the Lord. Imagine at that point, someone has committed adultery. Someone has lied. Someone has stolen. Someone has beaten a friend. Someone has slept with another person's wife. Someone has murdered. But God said, no, these are my people. If I consider their sin, their iniquity, they will all perish. And so he decides to give a sacrifice. And that was his son, Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. So Isaiah says, surely he has borne our griefs and he has carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Imagine all the pain, all the anguish, all the torture, all the mistreatment that was supposed to be laid upon me, upon you. It is laid on Jesus Christ. Whatever you would have undergone, the stripes they would have given you, the torture you would have faced, but Jesus says, no, because of John, because of James, because of Andrew, because of brother so and so, I love him so much, he will not die. Let me die in his place. Praise the Lord. Can someone help me? I want to extend this a little bit here. So that because he had committed it, not because he deserved it, but he wanted me and you to be saved. Praise the Lord. Amen. And sometimes we take it so light. It is as if it is a normal case. When we live our lives the way we want, when we talk the way we want, no one minds. No one remembers that there is a price that was paid. There is someone who shed blood. There is someone who cried. There is someone who carried a cross. There is someone who spent a night and he prayed, and the Bible says his sweat was dropping as great drops of blood in the garden. There is someone who was forsaken, and the Bible says that his father turned his back away from him at that time when he was lonely because of me and you. Gentlemen, fellow saints of God, let us not take the cross for granted. Apostle Paul tells us that we shall not continue to sin so that the grace of God will abide. No. We cannot continue to take the grace of God for granted. We are living in a season where people are no longer conscious of the wrongs they are doing. It has become a normal weakness. It has become just a mistake. Praise the Lord. That there is no time to go down on our knees and we tell God that we are sorry for all that we have done. This costed somebody's blood. This costed sleepless nights. This costed shame and torture and mockery. Someone to be spat in the face. It is good. When you were ministering, I heard you sing a song saying that I give myself away so that you can use me. Let God use you today.
Yes.
We're looking at what happened on the cross of Calvary. Now, when he was coming in, he was a neat man. Somebody helped fix this. Before crucifixion, actually the Bible says in Isaiah 52 and verse 13, but as many were stoned at thee, his visage was so merry more than any man, and his form more than the sons of man. That his visage, his nature, his form, because of the torture, because of the beating, because of the thorns, because of the way they treated him, bruised everywhere, bleeding everywhere, his visage changed. You could not recognize that this is the same Jesus who healed the sick. This is the same Jesus who cleansed the lepers. This is the very Jesus who worked out miracles. He had totally changed. He had been beaten and disfigured. Praise the Lord. He came in as a smart man, putting on a watch, properly dressed, in a shirt and a trouser, looking very nice. Amen. And we can try to pull this one up. Yes. Can have your seat, brother. Thank you. If someone entered from the other side, it may be hard for him to recognize that this one is Dennis. True or false? What has happened?
You have loaded him with our burdens.
Praise the Lord. Now, around this one, Brother James, let someone give you a mic. Brother James, help me translate this in Kiswahili.
Akili.
I know these days, sometimes, because we are multinational. Okay. Our pronunciations may not be. Okay, Pastor Moro, help me. You will translate something small from English to Swahili so that our dear people who are around, maybe who may not be familiar with my pronunciation, they may get it in another version of the Swahili.